الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، والجنة للموحدين، ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه والتابعين لهم وعلينا معهم أجمعين. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our creator, our sustainer, our provider, our cherisher, and the greatest of salutations in abundance upon his most beloved and the most beloved Habib, our master, Sayyidina wa Mawlana, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, upon his noble and illustrious of companions, the Sahaba Hikram, and upon his noble and purified household, Ahlul Bayt Ajma'in. Alhamdulillah, it is with the grace and bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has blessed us once again to attain His reward, His mercy, His compassion, His forgiveness, His prize in the month of Ramadan, 1436 Hijri. And we are on the threshold now of the month of Ramadan exiting, and we welcome the first of Shawwal, which is the day of Fitr, Eid al-Fitr, a joy and festivity for all Muslims throughout the globe for the breaking of the fast that they have obeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the glorious and noble month of Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us that we are able to see this happy occasion, this joy, this reward, this mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we are able to celebrate His mercy, give thanks to Him, are grateful to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala for all the strength that He has allowed us to stand in the month of Ramadan, the fasting which He has allowed us for His worship subhanahu wa ta'ala, the taqwa and piety which is instilled into our hearts in the month of Ramadan. And we thank Him for the day of Eid, a day of giving gratefulness and gratitude to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, a day to celebrate with our family, with our friends and our community, a day of rejoicing after celebrating one intensive month of ibadat and qiyam and siyam and fasting and standing and intensifying our worship. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us this day as a reward, so we may glorify Him subhanahu wa ta'ala and enjoy the benefit that He has placed in this day. Alhamdulillah, as we have said before we pass on the message of thankfulness and joyousness to the Muslim Ummah throughout the globe, month of Ramadan, we must give thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has allowed us to stand every single night to worship Him, that He has allowed us to fast from dusk till dawn. He intensified our worship, He gave us the strength, He gave us the willpower to worship Him in order, not for His benefit, but rather for our benefit. The mannerism which He has allowed to inculcate in this month, the characteristics of taqwa, piety, the good akhlaq of generosity, of empathy, of mercy, of compassion to our fellow human beings, which He has allowed us to enable ourselves to equip our hearts and our soul to purify ourselves. We make dua and supplicate to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has will allow us inshallah to maintain these habits in the other 11 months of the year. Like this is saying that the month of Ramadan is like Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, and the other 11 months of the year are like his brothers. Because of Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, all his brothers were forgiven. Like that, the month of Ramadan, because of it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives us for the 11 months that we may have disobeyed Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. It was also a month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helped us with His divine mercy to what is known as tarbiyatul irada, to break our will, to make it submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for us to acknowledge that we are slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He allowed us to break it for the simple reason when that moon was sighted for the first month, on the first day of Ramadan to be celebrated, we found ourselves in the masajid in time to read our salah and our prayers in congregation. We found ourselves worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, standing in the night, reciting the Quran of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, reciting the tasbih, the istighfar, the salawat and durood, the wadaif. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has broken our will so we may submit to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We found ourselves wanting to read the Quran more. We found ourselves wanting to stand to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more. We found ourselves wanting to supplicate to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is the first understanding of the dimensions of taqwa. Allah ta'ala was Ghafur Rahim, and He allowed us to break our will and nourish our will so it may only submit to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now inshallah we make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us now to continue for our will to submit towards Him throughout the other 11 months of the year. May we forever frequent the masjid for our salah in congregation. May we increase the recital of the Quran. May the recital of the Quran not come to an end, but rather increase. May our tawbah and istighfar continue and increase in the other 11 months of the year. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has also given us the chance, what is known as tazqiyatun nafs, for the purification of our soul. He allowed us to become more compassionate, more merciful. He allowed us to purify our ego. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed us to overcome the evil characteristics of backbiting, of lust, of shahwa, of jealousy, of hirs, of greed, of malice. And He allowed us to place in our hearts qualities of love, compassion, generosity, service to humanity. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed us to instill into our hearts that we fell merciful to another creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We became more generous. We helped the Muslim ummah as well as humanity. We gave out more. We did not restrict our hands, but rather extended our hands. And the feeling of generosity was so overwhelming that we have fed people. We have given out charities in abundance. We have helped the orphans. We have helped the destitute, the pure, the poor and the needy. And we make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He allows this characteristics of mercy, compassion, generosity to increase and to continue in the other 11 months of the year. That now we must not have impatience, intolerance, that rather greed and shahwa, lust, malice, hatred must disappear and not re-enter into our hearts. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has also blessed us with another dimension of taqwa in the month of Ramadan, that He allowed us for tasfiyat wa ruh, the purification of the soul. He has allowed us for our soul to reach closer to Him. Therefore we felt that the nights when we got up for tahajjud, when we got up for fajr, when we got up for suhoor, when we got up for qiyam, when we put our heads down in sajda, the slightest of whispers reached the heavens of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We found ourselves more interactive with our Creator. We found ourselves more near to Him, in proximity to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. We communicated with Him by recital of the Quran. We stood up and begged Him. We cried in His court. We felt His presence in our lives, and we thought this presence, and we educated and we purified our soul in the souls of our wives, our husbands, our children. And we make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our soul every day continues to soar towards Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, to reach His court subhanahu wa ta'ala, to ever feel His presence, qurbi ilahi, in proximity, in nearness to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And alhamdulillah, this glorious month of Ramadan has come to an end. How sad it is that the days pass very quickly. The barakah of time is slowly starting to go away, that we do not have enough time to appreciate the month of Ramadan. Allah Ta'ala has given us life once more to have experienced it. We make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to experience it again for years and years to come. And alhamdulillah, it is the day of Eid, the day that we return back to our normal routine, in the sense that we have broken away from the month-long end of fasting. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us this day as a reward, as a prize giving to the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Therefore, how we should spend it: in thankfulness, in gratitude toward him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, praising him, giving thanks to him, acknowledging him for all that he has given us, making dua that all our ibadat, our worship, our qiyam, our siyam are accepted by him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he rewards us not only in this dunya, but also in the year after, in the akhirah, that every single reward that he has placed for us in this month may benefit us in this dunya, may benefit us in the qabr, may it benefit us in the akhirah. It is also a day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has allowed us to ordain with our family, with our friends, with our children, with our community, in solidarity with the Muslim ummah throughout the globe, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are one ummah, one day unified in celebration, in giving thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May we go to our Eidgah, to our masajids, in our multitude, may we go there reciting our takbir aloud and intensifying our takbir from the time we leave the masjid to the time we come back home. May we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May we meet one another, smile, give thanks to each other, increase our love for our fellow Muslim brothers, our fellow human beings, greet one another, our children, our community, and that closeness that we felt, that love that we have for each other, that compassion and mercy and that brotherhood that we have, especially on the day of Eid, may it be throughout the year, every single day of our lives, inshallah. Our children, our family members, that even on the day of Eid, we overcome and overlook our shortcomings, our arguments, our disagreements, and we have silatul rahm, the maintaining of family ties. And what is a great command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, may this greeting, this hugging, this rejoicing with our family, may bring us closer to one another for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May the bond of family be strengthened, and may the bond of friendship be strengthened in this day, inshallah. That there are great sunan and the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, spending time with our family, spending time with our friends, spending time with our community. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam sunnah of increasing the takbir and the glorification of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that coming to the platform of the Eidgah, where we are in congregation, supplicating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a ummah, a unified, a symbolism of an entire unified ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So inshallah, we make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah ta'ala keep us unified. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us. Allah ta'ala guide us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward every ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, every slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for all that he has done in the month of Ramadan, inshallah. And we wish each and every Muslim Eid Mubarak, Eid al-Fitr Mubarak. Allah Ta'ala grant you a happy day, a joyous day, and throughout the world where Muslims are being persecuted, where they are being punished, Allah Ta'ala grant you victory upon your oppressors. Make the dua of the ummah on this great day, on this joyous day, this reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all the ibadat, for all the Muslims. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase you in taqwa, increase you in piety. To all our Muslims in Palestine, in Burma, in Iraq, in Kashmir, in Africa, in the Indo-Pak subcontinent, throughout the world, Allah Ta'ala grant your strength, Allah Ta'ala grant your victory upon your oppressors. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you for all the patience, the sabr, the tolerance that you have been able to hold, especially in the month of Ramadan, despite the circumstances that you are undergoing. You're still fasted, you're still worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you abundantly. And to the Muslims of South Africa, may you have a wonderful Eid, may you have a joyous Eid, may you have a Eid that is full of fruits from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, full of reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah ta'ala guide you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow you to inculcate all that you have learned and practiced throughout the other 11 months of the year, inshallah. I am Mufti Muhammad Farooq Sufi, inshallah. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us, to forgive us, to have mercy upon us. وَمَا عَلَيْنَا إِلَّا الْبَلَاغُ وَآخِرُ دَعْوَانَا أَنِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ.